I am Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like the session, press the like button, share the video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, you'll get the benefit of a whole lot of exam relevant videos which we upload. You'll get the notification of the same. Once I start the video, at the time of, you know, let's say when I wrap it up, at the end, revision will be done, and that revision is going to be very beneficial for you because I'll be actually pronouncing the names twice, maybe thrice. That's how you'll be able to retain these names in your mind if there's any difficult name. Let's start with the first question, which is about Irani Cup 2019. Here I need to mention the name of the winner, as in the team which has actually won, Irani Cup. So when we say, when we talk about Irani Cup, I have to talk about the Ranji Trophy as well. Ranji Trophy, which was discussed in the previous video, won by Vidarbh. So similar thing has happened here as well. Vidarbh has actually won. Vidarbh has won Irani Cup also. So when I mention such a thing, I'm going to discuss something else as well. First of all, write it down. I'm saying Vidarbh has won Irani Cup. Vidarbh has already won Ranji Trophy also. I am saying that both of them are associated with cricket. I have to tell you one more thing here, that Vidarbh has beaten, Vidarbh defeated rest of India. If I say defeated rest of India, there's a possibility you may misconstrue it. So I'm going to tell you that rest of India does not mean that rest of India, the entire rest of India, you know, was defeated. I'm trying to say rest of India is the name of the, rest of India is the name of the team. Rest of India is the cricket team, and Vidarbh beat rest of India. So I'm saying Irani Trophy 2019 winner, Vidarbh beat rest of India. We'll start with the second question, which is about Grand Cross of Order of Civil Merit winner. Now, you haven't heard much about such a thing. Sushma Swaraj, who's our External Affairs Minister, she actually bagged that award. She was actually given this prestigious award. You need to know that this award is associated, or this award is associated with the country Spain. That means this is the prestigious award of Spain, which was actually given to Sushma Swaraj. I'm saying Grand Cross of Order of Civil Merit winner. There I'll be mentioning the name of the person, that is Sushma Swaraj, and she is the external affairs minister, and she has won this award. You need to know the name of the nation which actually provides this award. The name of the country is Spain. Write it down for sure. The next question is World Radio Day, which is observed on 13th February. World Radio Day, I'm talking about United Nations. World Radio Day is observed on 13th February. Here I'll be mentioning the theme of it, which was dialogue, tolerance, and peace. Dialogue, tolerance, and peace. See, whenever I talk about the days, I don't mention the themes deliberately, because if I find it important, then only I'm writing it. Then only I generally write it. So I'm saying World Radio Day is observed on 13th February, and the theme was dialogue, tolerance and peace. Mascot of National Games 2022. First of all, when I start such a question, I have to tell you that National Games 2022 will take place in Meghalaya. Meghalaya will be this host, a place. Basically, so I'm going to mention the mascot here. The mascot is Smiling Clouded Leopard. The mascot of National Games, which will actually take place. I was saying Meghalaya is the state which is going to, you know, which is going to conduct, will be the host city which is going to actually conduct National Games of the year 2022. So Meghalaya is the place, and the mascot, Smiling Clouded Leopard. Mascot will be Clouded Leopard, Smiling Clouded Leopard. Festival of India conducted in Nepal. When I talk about such a thing, it sounds odd. You must be thinking that I'll be actually naming or writing the state here. And here I'm talking about another country. So I'm trying to tell you something here. Festival of India is basically a month-long festival sort of thing, which is actually going on. Something is going on right now, a month-long festival which will actually take place for the entire month in Kathmandu, Nepal. What I'm mentioning here is that youth should be aware that, like, what sort of similarities are there between India and Nepal. So such similarities are actually being disclosed, such similarities are being shown basically in the festival. So Festival of India is conducted in Kathmandu, Nepal. I'm saying it is a month-long festival where the similarities between both the countries are actually being shown. Let's move to the next question, which is about ASEAN India Youth Summit. So ASEAN India Youth Summit, the place is Guwahati. I have to tell you the venue of it. So Guwahati is the place. Guwahati, Assam. So Guwahati, Assam is the place, ASEAN India Youth Summit 2019. Now the next question is about Frank Bainimarama. So Frank Bainimarama is basically the Prime Minister of Fiji. If I just say that, you will not be able to retain it easily. So I am writing it here. PM, Fiji, PM. So PM of Fiji, Frank Bainimarama, he has been awarded. Awarded with what? Frank Bainimarama awarded with Sustainable Development Sustainable Development Leadership Award So Sustainable Development Leadership Award Sustainable Development Leadership Award was given to Frank Bainimarama, who is basically the Prime Minister of Fiji. Here I wish to actually give you some, you know, more information, which is World Sustainable Development Summit. World Sustainable Development Summit. If you don't write it, you will be losing, you know, one question, I'm telling you. You have to write it down. World Sustainable Development Summit took place in New Delhi. There at that summit, as you can relate it with the name, I was saying World Sustainable Development Summit. So which was actually held in New Delhi, there he was awarded with that Sustainable Development Leadership Award. Who's that person? He is Fiji's Prime Minister and his name is Frank Bainimarama. Next question is Saina Nehwal and Saurabh Verma. As we know them as badminton, super badminton players, so I am going to talk about the same thing. They have won national badminton championship. So Saina Nehwal and Saurabh Verma won national badminton championship. So how could both of them win that? It happened in a way, as you all know, when we talk about tennis, lawn tennis and, you know, their tournaments, we know that there's one men's singles title and there's one women's singles title. So we are going to discuss that women's singles was actually lifted by Saina Nehwal. Here she won women's singles and Saurabh Verma won men's singles by beating Lakshya Sen. Saurabh Verma beat Lakshya Sen and Saina Nehwal beat PV Sindhu. So PV Sindhu was actually beaten by Saina Nehwal. She bagged national badminton championship title. So national badminton title was actually given to Saina Nehwal and Saurabh Verma. They won that. Pan India Single Emergency Helpline number is 112. 112. See, we know a little bit about it because they were actually there in other states already. So there's nothing new, but you just need to know that ERSS, when I write it, I'm saying that Emergency Response Support System. So I have to say that Pan India Single Emergency Helpline number 112 under Emergency Response Support System. So under Emergency Response Support System, 112 has become the Pan India Single Emergency Helpline number now. Undaunted Saving the Idea of India, authored by P. Chidambaram. If I actually mention something in quotation, I actually talk about the books. So here the similar thing is happening here, that is why I have written author here. And I said that Undaunted Saving the Idea of India was authored by P. Chidambaram. We all know about him. So P. Chidambaram has written this book. So P. Chidambaram has written this book, that is Undaunted, Saving the Idea of India. The next question is Asian Cup 2019. If I have added this word football here, there is a reason behind it. It is to actually tell you that Asian Cup is associated with football. Asian Cup is associated with football. Asian Cup 2019 winner Qatar. And when I say Qatar, the answer is incomplete because I have to tell you who was the runner-up. The runner-up was Japan. Generally, consistently, Japan has been actually, you know, lifting or winning the title. So, beating Japan was a thing to be discussed. Here I am saying Asian Cup 2019 won by Qatar by beating Japan. The next question is ISRO's Human Space Flight Center venue. See, I have to tell you that Human Space Flight Center was inaugurated at the headquarters of ISRO only. And we all know the headquarters of ISRO is in Bengaluru. Headquarters is in Bengaluru, that we all know. There at the headquarters of ISRO, they have inaugurated Human Space Flight Center, which is about the end-to-end. I have to tell you about Gaganyaan project. See, if it is about Gaganyaan project, they will be actually looking after the Gaganyaan project wholly. Through that, I am saying ISRO's Human Space Flight Center was inaugurated at the headquarters of Bengaluru and they will take care. This Human Space Flight Center will look after the Gaganyaan project completely. The next question is about National Productivity Week. Here, I will be actually writing the week only. I cannot talk about the date here as it has week. So, I have to talk about the dates. 12 to 18th February. 12 to 18th February is the National Productivity Week. Add something else to it. That is Road Safety Week, which was observed this year from 4th to 10th February. I'm saying Road Safety Week. Road Safety Week. See, this is the question that you cannot skip. Road Safety Week, write it down for sure. 4th to 10th February. It was observed this year. During that period, so that is why I am mentioning it. Both the questions are significant, but that was one is even more significant. That is why I am rewriting it. I am saying National Productivity Week observed from 12th to 18th February this year and Road Safety Week was observed from 4th to 10th February this year. The next question is Indian History Congress venue. Indian History Congress venue. So, when I talk about Indian History Congress, it was actually held in Bhopal. Bhopal, referring to Madhya Pradesh, so Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh, Indian National Congress. See, at times when I generally say that it is going to happen or it has happened, there is a possibility the video gets published later. There is a possibility, so you can understand when I am talking about the venue of some place, please understand, take it like that only, that it will take place or it has already happened. That does not make any difference. I have to tell you the venue, that's what I'm disclosing here. That Indian History Congress venue, Bhopal, 2019. International Mother Language Day. It is international, emphatically telling you, stressfully, forcefully telling you, it is International Mother Language Day, which is observed on 21st February. Which is observed on 21st February. Lance Nayak, Nazir Ahmed Wani, we have heard about him. Posthumously, I have to write it like, you know, posthumously has been given the gallantry award, that is Ashok Chakra. So Ashok Chakra was after death given to Lance Nayak Wani. Lance Nayak Ahmed Wani, Nazir Ahmed Wani awarded with Ashok Chakra. We all know that it is the gallantry award. Sushil Chandra appointed as election commissioner. See, I'm not talking about Chief Election Commissioner here, that you need to know. Chief Election Commissioner is Sunil Arora. Chief Election Commissioner is Sunil Arora. Here I'm talking about Sushil Chandra. So I'm saying he is Sushil, he is Sunil. Sushil Chandra, Election Commissioner, Chief Election Commissioner is Sunil Arora. We'll start the revision immediately. We'll start with Irani Cup, which is associated with cricket won by Vidar by defeating rest of India team. India, name of the team is rest of India. So Grand Cross of Order of Civil Merit winner, the award, prestigious award of Spain, was given to Sushma Swaraj. Sushma Swaraj is our External Affairs Minister. World Radio Day is observed on 13 February and the theme of it was Dialogue, Tolerance and Peace. The next question is, mascot of National Games 2022. Meghalaya is the venue of National Games 2022 and the mascot is Smiling Clouded Leopard. Festival of India conducted in Kathmandu, Nepal. ASEAN India Youth Summit venue, Guwahati, Assam. Frank Bainimarama, who is the Prime Minister of Fiji, awarded with Sustainable Development Leadership Award at World Development, at Sustainable Development Summit 2019, which took place in New Delhi. Saina Nehwal and Saurabh Verma won National Badminton Championship. Pan India Single Emergency Helpline number, that is 112, under Emergency Response Support System. P. Chidambaram has written Undaunted, Saving the Idea of India. That's the book basically. Asian Cup 2019, winner Qatar, defeated Japan here. ISRO has actually launched Human Space Flight Center at, they inaugurated this project, they inaugurated it at their headquarters in Bengaluru. National Productivity Week was observed from 12th to 18th February. Road Safety Week was observed from 4th to 10th February. Indian History Congress, venue Bhopal, 21st February, International Mother Language Day. Ashok Chakra, posthumously given to Lance Nayak, Nazir Ahmed Bani. Election Commissioner, new Sushil Chandra, don't get confused with Chief Election Commissioner, who is basically Sunil Arora. Wrapping up, thank you.